Today we're going to walk through an example of selecting the appropriate enclosure cooler for your outdoor control cabinet. So in this example, we're going to basically size an enclosure cooler for the figure you see there to the right. So this is an outdoor application where the back of the control cabinet is against the building and the rest of the surfaces are open to the environment. So the boundary conditions you see over the left here, these are potential boundary conditions or environmental requirements you might see from a customer. And these would be dictated by the components that are in your system and the environment that's going into or where in the country it's being deployed. So the max outside air temperature based on the climate would be 95 degrees Fahrenheit. The max inside air temperature, again, mostly dictated by the survival temperatures of the electronics, is 120 degrees Fahrenheit. The waste heat or the electronics power dissipation, this can be found by summing all the data sheets and waste heat from your components in your system. We're estimating that as 1000 watts. And the dimensions of the enclosure are 60 inches tall, 36 inches wide, and 30 inches deep. So that's mainly all the inputs you need. We'll walk through the selection tool and you'll see some of the calculations and we'll talk about what's going on with the tool. But basically that's all the inputs you need and the tool should be fairly straightforward to run. So the first box is basically selecting your units of measure. The top right, the cooler mounting location, this is anywhere available that you can mount your enclosure cooler. So this might be dictated by the customer if there's any volume constraints or things of that nature. But in this case, we'll say that the back surface is not available, but all other sides are available for mounting your enclosure cooler. The next would be the cabinet dimensions. And again, we have that out there. 60 inches tall, 36 inches wide, and 30 inches deep. The next one on the right here is surface finish, and it was in the picture, if you remember, a light gray. So that again will work into some of the emissivity calculations working on the back end of the tool. Insulation, this is if you have coverings or things of that nature that might be blocking heat from going in and out of your cabinet. You can click on the question mark here if you want to kind of go into what's being assumed there if you click yes or no. But in this case and in most cases, there's no insulating going on in this system. And finally, it's the enclosure cooler conditions. So the maximum allowable air temperature inside your cabinet, we said that was 120 degrees Fahrenheit. The maximum expected air temperature outside, we said that was 95. And the waste heat was 1000. Then the final box here is running some calculations to dictate how much additional or less heat you might need to remove with your enclosure cooler based on some of the solar and airflow conditions. So the solar is how it sounds, is if you have a delta T and you have sun coming down, it's going to add heat into your system. The suggestion here is to use two adjacent surfaces. That gives a good approximation for an outdoor environment. So we'll say the top and left in this case are subject to solar loading. And then the airflow is any surface that's available for free convection. So depending on the delta T, again, this could add or subtract heat from your system based on those convective properties. And here, again, we'll say the back surface does not get any free convection, but all other surfaces do. And that's all for inputs. So you can come down, calculate your selection, and it'll run the calculations. And what it'll output here is the cooler requirement. So this is the actual amount of heat that your enclosure cooler must dissipate. So most of the enclosure coolers have ratings or dissipation numbers associated with them. And this is the number that you need to overcome in this system. And then if you drop down further, it'll give you all options and results. And the one highlighted here in green, the VCC 2000, that's able to meet the requirement with some margin, and that's your lowest price point. So it'll always select the lowest price point first. So hopefully that gave you a good idea of how to use the enclosure cooler. If you have any questions or any unique circumstances, please give us a call and we'd be happy to help and run some of our in-house tools as well. Thank you.